Okay, so this sphere is at a higher temperature than this sphere. So when they are brought into thermal contact, heat is going to flow from this sphere to that sphere. But the question says that no heat is transferred to the surroundings. So whatever heat lost by P is also the amount of heat gained by Q. So we can write an equation here. Because they are both made of steel, they have the same specific heat capacity. But because this guy has a larger mass, this guy has a larger heat capacity. So the mathematics will show you that the final temperature will be closer to the initial temperature of this sphere rather than this sphere. Actually, by intuition, you have gotten the answer. Just imagine if you are mixing one big tub of water at 80 degrees Celsius and a teaspoon of water at 20 degrees Celsius, the final equilibrium temperature, surely you can see that it's going to be much closer to 80 degrees Celsius. All right, that's it. Ta-ta.